Chris is unloading that bike off the stand here because you guys know that we just did the interfering digital, Dakota digital gauges and the Hogtune wild boar audio. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the bike out for a stroke because I actually want to feel that stock M8 on this 22. Plus, when I get back, Chris and I are going to put it on the dyno and we're going to give you guys the insight of what the numbers are of that 22 limited stock. And today, we're going to tear that engine down and start the 131 build. The big bore.
Recording.
Ooh, what is that? I just looked over and seen it. Okay.
The R-River presents the Big Bore Build Series here on YouTube, where we take a 2022 Harley Davidson Roadrunner Limited for build a touring performance bagger, which will be known as the Big Bore.
I'll be back, Chris.
Scotch whiskey, not very smooth, like snake bite cure from the medicine man. Not bad poison if something to soothe. It's a whole other world in the palm of your hand. Out of this world and out of your mind, just like it don't matter what you're leaving behind. Try and change your life and change your whole point of view, but no matter what you do, it's the same old you. Wherever you go, there you are. You can run from yourself.
Guys, I was just trying out that Wild Boar audio by Hogtunes because, you know, guys, we've upgraded that stereo as well as we just installed from Fairing Exchange the interfering colored match interfering. Is that not awesome? And of course, if you're looking at the bike from here, you can definitely see something else. Dakota digital gauges. Look at that. They're badass. I'm loving it. Steph's got to get a picture for a post, guys, and then I'm going to talk to you. This is the first time I've sat on the bike, honestly. All right. Let's talk a little bit, y'all. You're going to have to give me just a second. I'm going to get this GoPro where I want it. Right here is Rick Rack. If you're wondering what that is, we run Rick Rack GoPro mounts. What degree is it out here? Let's see. Okay. That is not right. It is not 61 fucking degrees out here. That is not right. I don't know what the hell's going on there. As you can see, getting my first fill of this 2022 Harley Davidson Limited. Okay. I'm like flipping with this thing, the CB thing. I don't use a CB. I think I'm going to take that out. Absolutely, my opinion, don't like that plastic look, especially after you got this amazing setup in front of you. Look at these speakers. They're just killer. Wild Boar Audio here once again, guys. And Paul from Fairing Exchange and the crew painted these lowers to match our bike. Hey, man, with our inner fairing. Let's feel this. Of course, the clutch is different now, guys. It's not a hydraulic clutch. Went back to the cable style clutch. So a little different. I actually kind of like it. My mirrors, everything's not perfect, guys. We're going to change out the bars. We're going to do KST. We got a little something in store for y'all. Something new that we're going to be doing from KST. Just for us, but not really. It's going to be for y'all, too. Okay, it's a new bike. It just, the clutch is, it feels different. The clutch is farther out. Feels a lot different than that, than my old bike, or maybe it's because they went back to the cable. It's smooth. It's new. What do you expect? So right here, I'm just going to roll you around here so you guys can look. We're just right here, a picture of Harley Davidson. And I'm going to take this back way.
road out there is pretty busy, and it'll just give me some time to actually clear my head. I need just a little bit of time on a bike. This build is great. If you guys don't know what you're watching, well, you're watching the Ornery One on YouTube here, and you are watching the progression of the Big Board Build here on YouTube, which we are calling the Big Board Build Series here on YouTube. And this is the first time I'm riding the Big Boar. I am straddling the Big Boar. Wow. Clutch is totally different. Just give you a second, guys, than what I'm used to on the old Road Glide Special. Okay, first thing, my toe doesn't, I can't put my toe out as far because I hit that lower fairing. It's something new to me. Handlebars are super low. That's got to be changed. This awful windshield in front of me has to be changed. This seat is not my Mustang seat. Just going over some things that is bugging me. I'm going to pop my hood just a little bit and let the atmosphere of my helmet get right, and then I can pop the lid back down. All right, guys, you've seen me take this road whenever I took the Pan America from Picture Harley-Davidson and rode it for the first time. So we're doing this with a, this is the 22, this is the 2022 Road Glide Limited that Steph and I have just purchased. This is my first run on it, so I wanted to ride it and fill this M8 stock, absolutely bone stock. Nothing has been done to this bike. Today, when I get back, Chris and I are putting it on a dyno. We're gonna dyno it, and we're gonna give you guys the numbers that come from this bike off the dyno, okay? And then today, we start to tear down, and then we start building this bike to be the Big Boar. That's right, guys, you are watching the Big Boar Build Series here on YouTube. And that's exactly what this is going to turn into. 131 with all the additives, of course, Custom Dynamics, Legend Suspension, Mustang Seats, Memphis Shades, KSD handbars. We got fairing exchange already on here with their color match inner fairing. We have Wild Boar Audio by Hogtunes on here. We have Dakota Digital already on here. A lot of things are going to be changing on this bike, and we're looking forward to it. We're also talking to some other companies. Really quick, I want to tell you guys that we will have the first ever. It's a prototype right now that ChromeWorks is sending us for our exhaust. This is going to be badass. Y'all want to stay tuned for that, as well as our handlebars from KST. So, a lot of cool shit we're doing here with the Big Boar Build. What does this feel like right now? Well, it feels like a little bicycle. It feels so light. This thing's very nimble. My bike, the Road Glide Special that Steph and I have been riding, course, we have it rigged out with Legend Suspension. So this thing, it feels like a new bike, but it doesn't have that preciseness and that feel that I'm used to with Legends. I'm going over some pretty rough shit right here, and I mean, it rides fine. And then that's what most of us are going to notice. If we get on a new bike, we think it's the tits, right? Well, let me tell you, you take the tits, then you go get a boob job, and then you got Legend Suspension. That's the only way I can explain it. We're going to get down here just a little bit more, and we're going to open this son of a bitch up. One thing I'm getting used to right now, whenever I push my foot forward to shift, I am hitting that front fairing, so that's going to take a little bit for me to get used to. The heel shift, they've taken off. It used to come with a heel shift. Now they do not come with a heel shift. And another thing, this clutch is different. It's back to cable. It is not hydraulic clutch, and it is taking me a second to get used to that. All right, let's whip this dude. It's so quiet. I mean, it honestly, guys, I'm not trying to be a dick, but it almost feels and sounds like a metric bike. Shh, I didn't say that. I'm just being honest. All right, let's see what we got.
I don't know. It runs good. There's no doubt about it, guys. The old bike, it'll get out there and it'll get on down the road. It ain't what I want. So you guys, if you're wanting a good, dependable, great bike to get out there and tour around, I think this is the bike right out of the box. It's gonna run good. It handles great. It's a new bike, like I said. The throttle response is there. The power's there, but for what I'm used to, the torque ain't there. I should have almost brought the front end up whenever I did that right there. Now, I'm not taking it way up on the RPMs. I'm keeping everything kind of in line and not going, you know, just absolutely crazy. I let off a little bit when I shifted. I could hold down on that throttle and go through the gears. But I don't think you're supposed to ride them like this to break them in. But we're fixing to tear this motor down anyway. And somebody's going to probably get onto me and be like, "Ah, TJ, you shouldn't be doing it like that." Boy, she is nimble, though. I did want to feel the brakes on this thing. Oh, yeah, she stops good. And see, right there, I kind of went in a little heavy because I'm used to my setup on my bike. So I'm used to more here where I kind of lean. This thing I'm really palms heavy on. Just feels different going in the corner. So I'm going in and turning a little quicker than I'm used to. Because I actually ride about here and just feel that through. Now I'm up here. Yeah, I got to have more torque, man. And again, guys, we're running, Steph and I, and totally loaded. And you guys know we're running across the country absolutely everywhere. We definitely got her warmed up. It's a great feel, though, man. This bike, I think, is it for us. You know, we were trying to pick which bike would be the ultimate big board build. And I think we picked right because this is water-cooled heads. Of course, you guys know that we're going to take this ass in and make it look like a special, though, because Steph and I don't like the bobbed-off look of the stock bags and how they ended the fender back here. So we're actually going to do the stretch bags, bring that fender down. It's going to look like a special. We already got everything in. Larry got all that ordered at Pig Trail. Ah, she's got to open up, man. It needs a good ass, good breather on it, and some good exhaust. And it, honestly though, guys, you gotta understand what I'm riding all the time. I'm off a chopper, an Evo, that we've made pretty hot little bike, and then that Road Glide that we're on right now has a stage two in it. You better move, squirrel. The Road Glide that we're on right now, that special, has a stage two in it. So, and it runs great. It'll outrun this bike, there's no doubt, as it sets right now. Brakes are great, though. The handling on the thing, they're just agile. That's one thing about the new bikes, they're super agile. And this is a big bike, they say. But guys, honestly, to me, after riding them, they ain't that big, they ain't that heavy. I hear a lot of people say, "Well, I don't know if I could handle, or you know, I need a littler bike to get around with." Man, there's nothing to these bikes. Once you get used to them, they are agile. They do handle. Okay, I got to get back. We got to start recording. So today we're going to tear the bike down. And it really starts the big bore build as far as the engine was. Okay, once again, that was my first take on it. It runs good, but it's got to run better than that for Steph and I. All right, we'll go get Chris and let him bring it in. All right. So it's going to go straight from there, guys, and then we're going to go straight to the dyno. And then we'll give your numbers to you guys. A lot of you guys asked if we would do that. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to take it right off the truck, basically, put it on the dyno, get the numbers, and then build it with a 131, and then tell you what we get out of those numbers. All right.